Let's compare the initial release of Windows 10, released on 2015 July 29th with Windows 10 Anniversary Update. On the left we have the initial release of Windows 10, and on the right we have Windows 10 Anniversary Update. On the initial release of Windows 10, when you drag up the lock screen, it drags up the text and the image together, revealing the sign in page with a Windows logo in the background. On Windows 10 Anniversary Update, when you drag up the lock screen, it just drags the text and the picture stays where it is. The picture then darkens and the sign in page appears in front of it. Let's compare the Start menu. In the initial release of Windows 10, at the left of the Start menu, it shows your most commonly used apps. At the top, it shows your username and account picture, and when you click it, it gives you some account options. At the bottom it has File Explorer, Settings, Power and All Apps. When you click All Apps, the left-hand pane of the Start menu switches to displaying all apps. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, it automatically displays all apps. The text from the username, settings and power have gone and the profile picture has been moved to the bottom left. However, when you click the three lines in the top left of the Start menu, it temporarily shows the text besides the icons. In the initial release of Windows 10, the notifications icon is to the left of the date and time. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, the notifications icon is to the right of the date and time. In the initial release of Windows 10, in tablet mode, when you show all apps, the apps are shown in a pane to the left. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, in tablet mode, when you show all apps, the list is shown full screen, very much like it is in Windows 8.1. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, there is now an ink workspace. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, below the calendar, there is now an agenda setup. In the initial release of Windows 10, when you right-click the taskbar, the menu is white. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, when you right-click the taskbar, the menu is black. In the initial release of Windows 10, the taskbar properties looks the same as it does in Windows 8.1. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, it is called Settings instead of Properties, and it uses the Windows 10 Settings app. Let's compare the Settings app. In the initial release of Windows 10, the background is gray. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, the background is white. In the initial release of Windows 10, the word Settings is in capitals and it is to the left. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, it says Windows Settings instead of Settings, and it is sentence case and in the center instead of at the left. In the initial release of Windows 10, the search box is to the right. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, the search box is in the center under where it says Windows Settings. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, there are icons for the subcategories down the left. In the initial release of Windows 10, there are not. In the initial release of Windows 10, the word personalization is in capitals. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, it is in sentence case. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, the search box is to the left. In the initial release of Windows 10, the search box is to the right. This is a repeating theme throughout the Settings app. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, there is an option for a dark color theme. In the initial release of Windows 10, there is not. In the initial release of Windows 10, the user account control looks the same as it does in Windows 8.1. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, it has been updated. Let's compare the blue screen of death. In Windows 10 Anniversary Update, they have added a QR code to the blue screen of death. If you hold your phone up to this QR code, it will take you to Microsoft's website and tell you why your computer crashed. So take a photo of it with your phone now, and let me know in the comments why my virtual machine crashed. Goodbye.